Hello friends, this video on molecular basis of inheritance part 20 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now let us talk about the enzyme which helps in the process of transcription. So once we talk about this enzyme, then we can see how exactly the process of transcription takes place. So RNA polymerase is the enzyme which catalyzes the polymerization process. Now the way DNA polymerase plays a role in case of the DNA replication, in a very similar way RNA polymerase plays a similar type of role in the process of transcription, because here also actually a new strand is being synthesized based on the existing bases sequences on the template strand. So the same thing happens even here. So here RNA polymerase binds at the promoter region. So let us suppose if this is the DNA. So this was the two DNA and the black one is the template strand. This is the promoter. The green portion is the promoter. So RNA polymerase is the enzyme. So here this has been denoted as RNA polymerase. So this RNA polymerase will bind at the promoter site and then it reads the template strand and adds complementary nucleotides continuously. Now as the RNA polymerase moves along this, it reads the strand and it continuously keeps on creating the corresponding strand. That is the complementary strand is being created at the same time. For example, if on the template strand the sequence is something like say A, G, T, A and so on. So as it passes along the strand, it reads it and it also creates the complementary bases on the other side. So this is how it will keep on creating here the corresponding RNA segment. Now RNA is synthesized in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction. Why is it so? That's because if you look at the template strand, so this template strand runs from 3 prime to 5 prime direction. So when this synthesis happens, it happens in the antiparallel direction, that is from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. So now we will introduce exons and introns. Now why do we want to introduce it at this point? Because the RNA which gets synthesized by the end of the process of transcription, we find different regions on that RNA. Because why are we creating this RNA? So that this RNA in turn can code for proteins, or they can synthesize proteins. Now exons and introns are part of the genes, so they are a part of the RNA which is being created. So exons are the nucleotide sequence within a gene that codes for proteins. Now it has been observed that in the sequence, like even if you talk about the DNA from which the RNA is being created, in that DNA also there are certain regions which can code for protein and there are certain regions which cannot code for proteins. DNA anyways cannot directly code for proteins, but when this DNA forms RNA, some portion of RNA can code for proteins and some portion cannot code for proteins, and those portions are termed as exons and introns. So exons are those which can code for proteins, so they actually help in the process of protein synthesis. So it is present in mature RNA, that is the RNA which is being used for protein synthesis. So the DNA also has exons and introns, that is the DNA also has coding and non-coding sequences. From this DNA, mRNA is produced as a result of transcription. So as a result of transcription, initial mRNA is being produced. Now what is mRNA? We will get to know a little later. It is a type of RNA. For now you should know that. So this initial RNA which is being produced, this also has exons and introns. So exons are those which code for proteins. So exons are the blue regions. So these regions are exons and they code for proteins, whereas the regions in between are introns and they do not code for proteins. Now finally, the RNA which we need for protein synthesis, it should code for proteins. So we do not want introns. So the introns become undesirable in that case. So what happens? All the introns are removed by a process called RNA splicing. So we will discuss this process in detail a little later. So as a result of RNA splicing, all the introns are removed and the exons alone form the mature mRNA, and this mature mRNA is further used for the process of protein synthesis. It is used for protein synthesis. And what is that process called where RNA is used for synthesizing proteins? That process is known as translation. So that means at the end of transcription, initial RNA is produced, which has both exons and introns. Then introns are removed from that RNA and mature RNA is produced, and that mature RNA is further used for the process of translation. So exons are the expressed sequences. Why are they called exons? Because they are expressed sequences. So the name exons, expressed exons. So that is how they are exons. Whereas introns are those nucleotide sequences which do not code for proteins. So they will not code for proteins. That means they are not expressed. So they are present only in initial RNA, or which is also known as pre-mRNA. So it is present only here. It is not present in the mature RNA. It is not present in mature RNA. And why is it called introns? Because these are intervening sequences. So they act, they are like interrupts between the exons. So they are called introns. So these are exons and introns, and we will understand their significance a little later. So basically the entire process is somewhat like this. DNA has both exons, introns, and due to the presence of so much of exons, DNA directly cannot code for proteins. So DNA undergo transcription, it forms the initial RNA. Initial RNA also has exons and introns. This undergo RNA splicing, where all the undesirable introns are removed, and finally a mature RNA is produced which has only exons. So there are no introns. So these exons will undergo translation to form proteins, and that is how exons will get expressed through the traits in an individual.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.